The Lord has it set that He wants us to be fully dependent upon Him for everything. He says, I don't want you to depend on yourself, meaning for everything you are to rely fully on me. And He finds ways time and time again to take them to that place where they can't fix their issues, and only the Lord can fix their issues, and they will know again that He is the Lord who has delivered them time and time again. Now, I said this earlier, but it's easier said than done. I'm a person, and most of us are people, who want to ensure that we got it right. We want to fix it. We want to fix our job and our life and our health and our emotional issues and our marriages with ourselves, with our own hands. And we never cry out to the Lord. We are our self-fixers. Because you want to see it, you want your hands on it, and you want to be able to handle it. We don't want to let go and let the Lord take over, which is a requirement. It's rough. But the Lord wants to see us get to the point where we let go and let Him take over. And if we don't do it, and we forget that He's the one in charge, He keeps reminding us. And it's not fun when He does that, because He takes us to these places that we can't fix the problem. No way, and it requires a miracle. And when He does it, you say, yep, the Lord did it. The Lord is the one who did this thing, and He gets all the glory. So dependence, we like to depend on ourselves, but the Lord said, you must depend on me. I said earlier, a couple of weeks ago, I went to Kalahari Water Park in Wisconsin Dells with the kids. And in the theme park, probably a lot of you might have seen some of you there. In the theme park, they have something called a zip line. A zip line, you know, you're tied to this little string, and you got to take off and jump across. And you got to trust that little string. So I seen everybody do it. It's like, all right, my wife and my kids and all these other kids. And I get to the edge. And I look at the guy and I just want to make sure. I'm reading the signs. What's the weight limit? Can it handle me? I'm like, man, I'm 6'1", 220. Are you sure this could handle me? I want a guarantee. He said, dude, just jump. Just jump. He said, leap. And this is the Christian life. So I walked up, and you get to the point, you say, I must trust. And the Lord wants to see it in us that we must trust and let go and watch Him do His wonderful work. And I did it, and I'm here today. So it's good. It's okay. It works. So not going on again, though. Just did it once. One time's enough. But it was good, and I enjoyed it, all right? The Lord says, I'm going to get you to the place where you either leap off and trust me, or you got to run back. Don't run back. Going back into the darkness, going back into the Egypt. The Lord says, come here and let me take you to a wonderful, more deeper place.